Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be filming my memory spread and this will be for the week of September 16th through the 22nd. And for this week's plan with me, I have a really gorgeous fall themed kit. I feel like this is really kind of the first like really autumn kit that I'm using. And this is from Avenue K Design. The kit did come with a set of these rose gold foiled bow headers and they're super gorgeous. I don't have a whole lot of stuff in rose gold, but I will pull in whatever I can. And I probably will also mix metals and pull in some gold foil as well. And then for the kit, I picked up these three sheets. I can't really remember if this was a mini kit or if I just picked up these a la carte, but these three are pretty much enough for my planning style. So the first sheet here has the 9 full boxes and 3 quarter boxes here in the center. Then here we have a lot of half boxes, and I think this is like a third box. We've got some scallop labels, sidebar trackers, headers, some bow flags here, and 2 Build Do stickers, as well as 2 habit trackers. And then the last page here has the bottom washi, which is these 2 strips. We've got the washi strips, a set of date covers, and these bow checklists in the corner. So yeah, those are the sheets that I will be working with today. I don't know how much other stuff I will need to pull in, but I'll kind of figure that out as I go along. So yeah, if you're interested to see me plan with this kit, then go ahead and stay tuned. For my bottom washi this week, I initially wanted to use a Simply Gilded bow washi, mostly because the bows were rose gold foiled, and when I looked at the washi on the roll, the colors seemed to match the kit really well with like these more muted tones of like pink, yellow, and blue. But when I put it on my planner, the washi ended up being like so much brighter than it looked on the roll. So I don't know if that's happened to you guys where the color looks different, but I decided to lift it up and I just placed down the washi that came in the kit instead. I thought it was 2 separate strips, but it's actually 1, which makes it a lot easier to place down. And then I move on to my sidebar. For this week, I felt like the large hexagon in the corner actually matched the kit, so I did not white it out. And because the kit did not come with a quote box, I decided to write one in myself. And this is a quote that I've kind of seen floating around Instagram, and I really, really like it. It says, "My favorite season is fall of the patriarchy, and you know, the feminist in me is totally all about it." So I decided that was going to be the quote for this week. After I write it in the box, I go ahead and place it down on my planner, and then I used one of the rose gold foiled bow headers from the kit, but I noticed that they were cut just a little bit too narrow. It's not super noticeable, so that was okay, but it was just something I had noted. And I then put down the 2 Monday through Sunday boxes to track my happy moments and my dinners, and I had quite a lot of space in between all the boxes for this week because I wasn't filling up the bottom space with any other washi, and I'm just going in to write down the headers of all my sidebar items. Next, I go ahead and place down all of the date covers at the top, and for this week, I decided to write in my own dates because I didn't have any rose gold foil date dots or any date dots with fonts that match the style of this kit. And once I'm done with that, I go ahead and start on Monday. So I first put down a bow header at the top. I did have to white out the sides a little bit because, like I said, they were just a little bit too short. And then I used a quarter box from the kit with this rose gold foiled coffee cup that's from Hazel Sticker to mark my coffee on Monday morning. I wanted to mark that Monday was picture day, so I put down this large camera sticker that's from Planning in Mint, which is now Bloom Paper Studio. I always forget that she rebranded, and initially I had just written picture day under it, but I really didn't like how I wrote it, and I had changed it up a few times, so I ended up placing down a half box with it, and I like how that turned out a lot better. I then put down a rose gold foiled IEP sticker from J'adore Planning, and I used that to mark an IEP meeting that I had that afternoon. And then I decided to move to the bottom first so I knew how much space I had to mark the remaining items of my day. So at the bottom, I put down a full box and it had a little bit of white space in it. So in that space, I just wrote film plan with me. The brush lettering pen I'm using this week is from Zebra. It's in the extra fine size. And moving back to that middle section, I used one of those bow flags with this annoyed emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark that I got home super late that day. I had a ton of work to finish. And then I used a quarter box with a grocery icon from the Sparkly Studio to mark that I stopped by H Mart, which is a local Korean market, to grab some groceries. On that full box, I decided to add a little bit of foil by placing down a rose gold foiled bow, and I believe that is from Planning Like a Pro. Moving to Tuesday, I first started by placing down a washi strip at the top, and I also used this Remember script sticker from Rose Color Days. The first thing I wanted to mark on Tuesday was that my sister had her first real job interview, like for her career. So that was really exciting. And she got the job. So I'm really proud of her. I put that on a half box and I found this really cute fall colored banner from my leftovers collection. So I decided to pull that in to mark the exciting news. And then underneath that, I used a foiled post-it note from Hazel Sticker paired with a rose gold pen sticker from Little Star Plans to mark a meeting that we had that afternoon. I had another IEP, so I decided to mark this one with an IEP sticker from Happy Diet Stickers, and I just placed that on the full box. And then moving to the rest of my day, I put down a bow header with a strip of washi to mark my workout. I used this little shoe icon from Hazel Sticker. I just added those to my collection, and I've been loving them because I just feel like they're the perfect size, and they come in like every single color. And I had quite a bit of space left in the day, so I decided to use this really skinny box with a meal icon from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark what I had for dinner. And then at the end of the night, we just watched Terrace House, which is one of our favorite shows. And so I found this TV icon from Bubba Bear Studios, and I decided to use that because it matched the color of this kit. On Wednesday, I first started by placing down a full box at the top, and it does have this empty section in the middle, so I decided to use that to mark my IEP meeting. I pulled in another rose gold foiled flag from J'adore Planning to mark that, and then underneath, I used a foiled bow header with a, I think it's like a third box. That paperclip bow sticker is from Planner Frenzy, and I used that to mark a meeting I had after school, and then later that day, I went to happy hour with a couple of my friends, so I definitely wanted to mark that. The beer sticker I used is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams, and again, the brush lettering pen is from Zebra. I then put down a quarter box and a bow flag, but I decided to switch the order of them. So on the bow flag, I just marked that I went home, which isn't usually something I mark, but I definitely needed to fill up more space. And that car sticker is from Nicole Hutch Designs. On the quarter box, I marked that I had an ice cream sandwich for dessert that night, and I found this really cute cupcake foiled sticker, and I think that's from Magic Prince Co. It came in a little sampler, so even though I didn't have a cupcake, I felt like that was close enough, and I could bring in a little foiling, so I put that down, and then at the end of the night, I did edit a plan with me, so I pulled in this washi strip and edit sticker from Love Shira. Moving to Thursday, I first started by placing down a bow header at the top, and then I used this flag sticker from Echo Hui Craft Co. to mark a morning meeting that I had. The type of meeting I had was called an SST, which stands for Student Success Team, and it's just basically, you know, working with parents and teachers to figure out how to support a student who might be struggling in some area. So anyways, I put that down, and then I used a scallop label with this noodle eating emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark that I had just an instant ramen for lunch. I had a fairly productive day on Thursday, so I put that on a quarter box and used this rose gold foiled bow sticker. I can't remember what shop that is from. I think I got it as a sampler or part of like an anniversary sale or something. So I apologize, I can't remember off the top of my head. But after I got home, I did some recording, so I used a record sticker from Love Shira. Then my boyfriend and I did date night, so I put that on a half box and I pulled in this really cute couple sticker from Fox and Pip. At the end of the night, I just placed down a full box at the bottom, and I wanted to mark that I did some editing, so I put down this laptop sticker. I think that's from Sticker Blush, and I just wrote in edit. Now moving to Friday, I first started by placing down another washi strip at the top with this remember header from Rose Color Days, and the first thing I wanted to mark was TGIF because I was so excited it was Friday. I used a quarter box with this Happy Maru sticker from Paper and Milk, and I just brush lettered TGIF. I don't love how it turned out, but I didn't want to waste a box, so I just left it. And then that morning I got a pumpkin cream cold brew, which has been my favorite fall drink this year. I used a rose gold foiled coffee sticker from Hazel Sticker, and then I placed down a full box and wrote in a morning meeting I had in that little empty space. I went to the bottom and placed down a half box with this sleeping mask sticker from Bloom Paper Studio, and I just wanted to mark that we had a really lazy night on Friday, which is always nice to end a long week. And then above that, I did do a workout that night, so I used another workout shoe sticker from Hazel Sticker to mark that. I also wanted to mark that I got some happy mail that day. So initially I used this like more salmon color to mark that. So I placed down a bow header and a washi strip, and that mail icon is from the Sparkly Studio. Later on, I do switch that out for a different color scheme instead because I wanted to pull in more turquoise, but you'll see that in a couple minutes. Now moving to the weekend, I placed down a couple washi strips at the top, and I noticed that this kit did not come with a weekend banner. So I found this one from My Newest Addiction, and I thought it matched the kit pretty well, so I go ahead and place that on the top. Then on Saturday, I first put down a bow header with a full box. I do end up switching out that full box later on. And like I mentioned earlier, this is where I switch out the salmon colored boxes for the turquoise ones instead to mark getting happy mail. Now I'm moving back to Saturday. So in the empty space inside the full box, I put in a sleep-in sticker from Paper and Milk. And then I use this rose gold foiled bow sticker that is from Stella Bow Sticker Co. And then I put down a half box, or no, it's like a third box with a foiled boba sticker from Hazel Sticker to mark that I got some Ding Tea, which is like my favorite boba place. And we also did some groceries at Sprouts. We then had our friends over for game day, and we were playing this game called Scythe, but we were doing like the campaign version, so it took like quite a few days to finish. And so I think this was like the first of 3 days that we played. I put that on a rose gold foiled post-it from Hazel Sticker, and I believe that dice sticker is also from Hazel Sticker. We ended up having so much beer that day while we played, and so I put that on a half box, and the beer sticker is from the Coffee Monsters Co. I didn't really have anything else to mark, so I just put down a bow sticker from Planning Like a Pro to mark that after we finished our game sesh, our friends actually ended up staying pretty late. They didn't leave until like 12:30 because we were just hanging out and having more beers, and it was just a fun night. I decided to scooch everything up a little bit, I think because things looked a little crowded to me, so I moved up the weekend banner and just shifted everything on Saturday. Then before moving to Sunday, I decided to move the full box on Saturday because the one I had left was striped and I wanted a full box to be at the bottom of Sunday, but I didn't want the striped full box to be right next to the striped half box at the bottom of Saturday. I hope you understand that. So to prevent the two designs from being too close together, I decided to switch out the full box on Saturday. Now moving back to the top of Sunday, I placed down a half box and used the sloth sticker from Dizzy Daisy Dreams to mark that I had a really lazy day on Sunday, which is always nice. Then I used this planner sticker from My Newest Addiction to mark that I did some filming, and I love that sticker. It's so beautiful. Then underneath that, I used a bow header with a half box and a laundry sticker from the Sparkly Studio to mark that I did laundry that day. And then in that remaining little space, I used this flag sticker. I think it's from The Giving Girl and has a little bit of rose gold foiling on it, and I just use that to mark that I went to the grocery store. I already placed down that remaining full box on Sunday. That was the one I lifted up from Saturday initially, and in that empty space inside, I just marked the show that we watched that night. It was called The Chef Show, and we love watching food and cooking related shows, so this one is like right up our alley. It's really good, so if you guys enjoy food shows, I would highly recommend it. It's on Netflix, and I just left that rose gold foiled bow there from earlier, and again, that's from Stella Bow Sticker Co. That concludes my spread for the week, so I go ahead and move back to my sidebar and fill in all of my workouts, my happy moments, and my dinners, which is always the last thing that I do. And yeah, that is it for today's spread. I'm just quickly showing you guys these stickers that I have left. All of this will go into my leftovers pile for a giveaway later on. And now I'm doing a quick VivWiggle to show you guys all the foiling. I actually ended up sticking only with the rose gold foiling, which is why there wasn't quite as much foiling because I just don't own as much rose gold. But I felt like it was a perfect amount for this kit. It wasn't overwhelming, and it was just a few spots here and there of foiling, so I really love how that turned out. This kit from Avenue K Designs is so gorgeous, and I'm pretty sure I have a coupon code for her shop, so definitely check out my description box below for that code if you want to check out her shop. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching today. I hope you enjoyed this, and let me know if you have any questions. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye!